Hello everyone and welcome back. If you're like me, home is where I spend most of my time. This makes many days feel mundane and cyclical, and sometimes it tricks me into thinking that I'm not doing much. As I nurture my children, am I putting enough energy into nurturing myself too? These thoughts have pushed me to find ways to encourage myself. So, with this video, let me share 7 simple tips I use to stay motivated throughout the normal everyday. What we consume when we first wake up shapes much of how our day goes. I used to scroll for quite a while after waking, especially if I had time before the kids woke up. However, I noticed that scrolling allowed my brain to consume a ton of information without filtering. I'm sure you've felt that even when seeing positive things on social media, like an achievement, new purchase, fun vacation, or fancily decorated living room, you've felt the itch of comparison. If unchecked, this can make you feel like you're missing out and that your everyday life is nothing to be proud about. At some point, I had to tell myself that this is not true. My life is amazing. And every day, I use affirmations to shape my thoughts into thoughts of positivity and abundance. There are various ways I do this, such as reading verses during devotion time or reciting affirmations I've written down. By focusing my mind on being content and joyful, I am much more motivated to live fully. Physical health plays a big role in being motivated. Poor eating habits are often due to negatively coping with something or not putting enough care into our health. As food affects the body so much, it's vital to consume healthy and energizing foods. Plan and prepare foods that give you energy, where after you eat them, you feel better. As a sweets enthusiast, I understand the pull of a slice of decadent cake or a couple of fresh cookies, but I know they don't add to my health. My tip is to get in almost all food groups at every meal, especially fruits and vegetables. Fresh juices and green smoothies are also great ways to reach your daily quota. Motivation often becomes stifled when staying inside. The body is like a plant, so it needs water, nutrients, and sunlight to stay healthy and rejuvenated. Going outside gives your body a chance to breathe in some much-needed fresh air. This is especially wonderful if you've been in a building where the air is recycled and filtered. 10 to 15 minutes per day is enough to let the sun do its thing. Add some activities outdoors for more time outside. Just keep your skin protected. Even if the best you can do is sit in front of a window with the sun shining directly on you, the main thing is that your skin catches a few rays. Feeling alone can put a damper on our spark, so it's important to stay connected with those we cherish. Depending on your situation, you may find yourself at home with your little ones and most of your social interaction is with them. Like me, I'm home with my children all the time while my husband is between work and sleep, with a little time during the day to play with the kids. Your situation might be different. You're at home while everyone else is out of the house at work or school. Either way, I find that my social life is not very active, which can feel pretty lonely. What I find helpful is to connect as deeply as possible. Engage your playful and nurturing side with your children, have meaningful and close conversations with your husband, and talk often with extended family and good friends to strengthen those relationships. Cultivate your sense of belonging, and that will definitely keep you going. As the season changes and the cold sets in, the thought of crawling into bed and hibernating is very appealing. However, that won't help much to get you motivated. Balancing rest with focused motivation is key. While there are times when the body needs to rest outside of sleep time, such as during sickness or burnout, there is a line between laziness and intentional pausing. Personally, I get my best rest after I've accomplished something, whether it's as simple as cleaning the kitchen or as complex as recording, editing, and upload a video, like now. Rest is much more meaningful along with productivity. It's unrealistic to think that we should always be motivated. Sometimes life just takes a toll and we just need to refocus. At those times, just being content with where you are helps to take off some pressure, much of which is self-inflicted. Avoid comparing yourself to other moms and homemakers because all that will do is make you feel behind, which quickly decreases your internal motivation. Accepting the stage of life that you're in and working with that will help you find the joy in each small moment. Be proud of your role and who you are, and never become complacent. You can always be a better you. Motivation is like a wave, with highs, lows, wild currents, and calm ripples. Finding a few simple ways to balance it out will help us homemakers be content and happy with life at home. Let me know in the comments if any of these tips inspired you. I hope this video helps you find motivation, and I will see you next time. Until then, be well and be at peace.